Commission. The legal redress. Commission.
Redress ride.
The legal redress. Commission. The legal redress. Commission. The legal redress. Commission. The legal redress. Commission. The legal redress.
This is how we do it.
You a fool. You are an idiot.
Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, ladies and gents, we got some information for y'all, you all, however you want to pronounce it, however you want to put it, however you want to get it on a good foot. We got to do a new one of these because, it ain't that easy, huh? Somebody stop that man from crying. That's Eddie. Y'all stop that man from crying. He shouldn't be crying. Always crying. Always crying and whining. I'm going to give you something to cry about. Yeah, you going to be good? That's the introduction. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a couple of things we want to talk about. Oh, that's me stretching. Because I've been sitting in front of this computer for quite some time. Y'all don't need to see that. Not trying to open up that. Not trying to open up a can of worms or a can of whoop anuses. Take a look at this. Number 8, contracts, mortgages, or pledges against or with enemy or ally of enemy. Obligation of contracts. That's what we're concerned about, obligation. Does anybody know what obligations are? Let's close them people. I got Skype on. Y'all see how the pop-up is? I'm so glad it's not in my ear. Now, let's do that. Let's copy that because that's going to be one of the main courses of... Well, the main courses for the meal. Okay, suspension, limitation. Any person, not an enemy. Let's hold on to any person, not an enemy for right now. We're going to go to B. So when y'all pull this up, I want y'all to look at B for Brett. B, the good letter of the alphabet, the second one. And you know why I chose B? Because I had A and knew I couldn't top me. So now I'm just B. Any contract entered into prior to the beginning of the war. Well, you know the United States is still at war with somebody. Y'all do understand that, right? That the United States has never declared an end to the war of World War II. Never declared an end to the war of World War, Vietnam War, which was technically mini World War II. Or the Korean War. Or the war on terror. We still remain at war. That's my Internet Explorer. Internet Explorer 10. It does that for some dumb reason. Don't know why. We're going to get back to this. Ask me later. Telling me about war. We're going to get right back to that in a momento. But we got to stop Internet Explorer from Internet Exploring. You know, because it wants to Internet Explore. So, unexplore yourself. Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Don't y'all hear it? I can hear it. I know you can hear it. I hear a symphony. Oh, and she's lost. Sorry, this is one of my favorite songs. Symphony and Love Hangover. I just like the melodies. And this is the Supremes. Before they were just, they were the Supremes, and then they got greedy and big-headed, and they just became, that's right, that's like a pizza with no anchovies. Ooh, can't stand anchovies. That's why it's like a pizza with no anchovies. It tells me my YouTube ain't responding. I'm looking for my YouTube to respond. This says it don't want to respond. Can you tell us, Mr. Howard Cosell, why the internet is not responding? Okay, let's see if we can do a refresh. This is this Windows 10 thing. Look at that, it don't want to show up. Well. Let's see. It even says Windows Restore. Let's see. Okay. Why? YouTube.com uploads. There it is, folks. YouTube.com uploads. No more Restore. Gotta get rid of Restore. All right. We wasted enough time trying to find things and get this junk to work. Let me explain to you where we at with that document we were reading earlier. Is it this one? No, it ain't that one. Is it this one? No, it ain't that one. Nope, it ain't that one. Is it this one? Nope, it's not that one. That's the new document we're going to be showing you later. So y'all just, nope, it ain't that one. Is it this? Nope, it ain't that one. Oh, there one, that one. I want y'all to pay attention to something. Any contract entered into prior to the beginning of the war between any citizen of the United States, we're not citizens, but and any corporation organized within the United States and an enemy or an ally of an enemy, the terms of which provide for the delivery during or after any war in which a present enemy or ally of an enemy nation has been or is now engaged in anything produced, mined, or manufactured in the United States may be abrogated. Such citizen or corporation by serving 30 days notice in writing upon the alien property custodian of his or its election of abrogation of such contract. Basically, it says during times of wars, you're doing business with an enemy of the United States, you can basically tell them you're canceling the contract. You're going to abrogate the contract. Ladies and gentlemen, we're not going to tell you to do such a thing. We're not going to tell you that the October 6, 1917 Act makes you an enemy of the United States. And thus, you're doing business with a corporation of the United States. Interesting. Ain't it interesting? So that's one of the interesting tidbits that someone sent me, and they highlighted it in yellow so y'all could get it. Okay. Oh, look at that. Title 50. Interesting, interesting, interesting. All right, we're going to get rid of that because we're tired of saying, yeah, yeah, yeah. Now, those of you who are having a trustee's deed sale, there are some very interesting instructions here. We're just going to read one. And this document is called The Mortgage Killer, PDF. See if you can find it. We'll try to put it up on the redressright.org/PDF section of the site. But just am so overwhelmed with stuff that I don't have the time. Sorry, folks. Just don't have the time. Notice a default. You received that. You received that from a bank. Notice what they are telling you to do. The original lender shows evidence to support the fact that they advanced lawful U.S. states monies to John Doe. Here's the thing. Most people, well, they didn't loan me money. And we were saying they never lent you any funds. But technically they did. When they purportedly used the funds to acquire the property, they paid off the previous bank, thus creating the loan. It's just that never went through your hands because you gave them power of attorney. So they were acting in your behalf. To have! Okay. The original lender, original trustee, and original beneficiary would suffer any pecuniary loss from John Doe for not making any payments on to the original lender, original trustee, and original beneficiary. There was no fraud involved in signing and construction of the original promissory note dated the date of the original promissory note was signed, and signing and recording of the original trust deed of trust, MERS number, original loan number, MIN. Okay, now, let's understand something. There's a problem. Let me tell you something the banks do. We showed you in the last video, they stamp that roughly about 5 days later, paid to the order of. They have to wait. They can't do it immediately because you have the right to cancel that contract after a certain amount of time. So they have to wait. That's why it takes them a moment before they monetize it. Let's continue. The original contract between John Doe and the original lender was not unconscionable according to the law, according to contract law, but not having evidence of the meeting of the minds and full disclosure, valuable consideration was exchanged and offer and acceptance was evidenced by both parties signing a wet ink signature evidencing full commercial liability on their respective parts. Well, the banks don't sign. Okay, but this is somebody else's document, not mine. That the party signs, claiming liability can produce the original wet ink promissory note and deed of trust evidencing their security interests and standing to sue in court. The original lender did not create the credit or money advanced on behalf of the settler borrower from the deposit of the promissory note signed by the settler borrower on the original date signed by the promissory note. Failure to provide verified proof of each point within 21 calendar days, 14 business days, equates to 21 calendar days. No, it doesn't. Yes, it does. Every 7 days, you add 2 days. Okay. Let's go on. But that's only 18 days. No, it isn't. Because you got to remember, when you count 18 days, how many weeks is that? 3. Okay, so add 2 more days. Well, that's only 20. Yes, plus the date that you received or waited for them not to respond. 21 stupid calendar days. International law. 14 calendar days is United States domestic law. Let's continue. Failure to provide verified proof within 21 calendar days after receipt of the presentment will be tacit agreement and silence and acquiescence stipulating to the fact, not really, that the original lender, original trustee, and original beneficiary has no financial interest in the matter and will result in an estoppel and cause the party's name to be barred from proceedings of legal action to collect on any alleged owed debt. Now, this is a letter that you send to them. Okay? That's a letter that's in the document. Aight? Y'all got it? Aight? Okay. Now, those of you, as I mentioned before, who received the Notice of Trustee's Deed Sale, this letter happens to state, and I'm looking for it, it's in one of the paragraphs, so might be lower after that stuff. But basically it tells you you need to write on the Notice of Trustee's Deed Sale, revoked, / rescinded, / canceled, / terminated, like the Terminator. Okay? Just that simple. Just that simple. And you file it back into the records. Well, they won't let you write. Who won't let you write on it? You're the grantor. You can do anything you want. You're just filing a document. Well, they say it don't purport to filing a blah, 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 blah. They don't have any yes, they do. Because you're going to get a certified copy of that document. And that's the very same document that was previously filed. And under equal protection of law, they must file it. That's the law that obligates them to file it. But people don't know how to bring forth certain arguments. Okay? Get out of my way. I didn't ask you for your input, chirp, whoever you be. I was looking for that section. I know it's here. Oh, well, there's a lot of information. You see, this document is a lot of information. Y'all see? A lot of information. But that's not where we're at right now. All right, so we'll come back to that later. Yeah, we're going to say to the court document because this deals with it partially. This is the one for the web. We're going to put a bond number, BC, bond number. We can get rid of that right there. We don't need the number signed twice. Don't want to confuse the fiduciaries. All right. And the Social Security bond number. There. This is the property of the TLRC until processed and or negotiated. See, what's been happening is a lot of your items haven't been returned because it's not your property. If you mail something to someone, it becomes their property, especially when it's sent to their address with their name on it. So, you have to stipulate that it's your property.
You can't prove that.
Yes, I can.
Well, prove it.
Well, when you receive a Social Security card or a credit card, do they not tell you, even on the card, that that is not your property? It's the property of the bank or the property of the SSA, Social Security Administration? So it's the same thing. So now you're letting them know, this is my property. You don't own this. If you want to own this, you have to negotiate it. You have to process it.
Oh, well, that sounds reasonable.
Okay, then we reserve all rights, UCC 1-308, 3-415, and 3-419, 9-209 and 210.
What does 9-209 and 210?
Go look it up.
All right.
Okay, and then we put a number, AASA. I'd have no idea what that stands for. I don't have any idea what these numbers stand for.
Where'd you get them numbers?
I don't know. I just made them up. I just started tapping in the keyboard and those numbers popped up.
Oh, well, does it make a difference when people keep asking you where'd you get those numbers?
Yes, it does. That's why it makes a difference. Certified promissory note. Excuse me? A certified promissory note? What's a certified promissory note? Well, the banks get to write a promissory note. The Federal Reserve gets to write promissory notes. They're called Federal Reserve notes. The banks write their promissory notes called bank notes. Sorry about that. Some of the music is partially downloaded, but some of it was downloaded using Kaza.
Kaza?
Yes, Kaza. And sometimes Kaza did not record like it was supposed to. So some of the music is that way, and so I don't know until I hear it giving me static.
Static Shock! I used to like that cartoon. Oh, I like that cartoon, too. Boy, it was so sweet and so charming riding on his little skateboard, flying through the air, and using electricity to defend the world.
Stupid cartoon. Anyway, let's go on. Then we write pay to the order of. We put the company name and the account number there. Pay the sum of 300,000 in credits.
300,000 U.S. because credits is U.S. money. Currency.
Coupon bond.
Draw E. The United States Department of the Treasury.
Now, as we told you on the last video, I hope y'all paid attention because that's the video we're going to be uploading. It's going to be United States Department of the Treasury and that promissory, that thing with the trustee's deed sale. Okay, going to be covering both of those, so y'all be ready. All right. So, we did find out that that lien was not filed by the Treasury, but filed by an individual who filed it on behalf of the Treasury. In other words, as if he was representing the Treasury.
The memo line. People say, I can't read your memo line. Before you read the memo line, you got it.
The payor's account name, Redrones. National Social Security number, 000. We add three zeros to the front.
Why you do three zeros?
Because we didn't feel like doing four.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Is that really a Social Security number?
Yep, probably for the president, but I don't know. All right. Void after 21 days.
Where did we hear 21 days before?
Contract acceptance law.
Okay. Is that why you did it?
Nope. I just gave them 21 days. Okay. Let's go on. Memo line or memorandum line. Memorandum line is like a promise to pay. Just look that up today.
This certificate voucher certified coupon bond
is a printed authorization to the United States Department of the Treasury 1789 to disburse public money for this public debt backed by the payer's full faith and credit and bonded by a certified promise as recognized by international law. Executor, grantor, you know what we don't have to put anymore? We don't have to put without recourse.
No!
No, because it's already there. Interesting.
Are you sure the banks don't do...
That's right. The reservation of rights and the without recourse has to be explicit. So your signature, if you're signing any more contracts, whether it be the DMV, we want you to contact everybody and redo your signature. For all contracts, for all negotiable things, you're going to manuscript your name.
What does manuscript mean?
It means that you're going to spell it out like that in all capital letters.
Why?
You ain't got to do it.
No, I'm just asking why.
Because that's going to be your signature from now on.
But why would I spell my name all the way out?
Only on contracts. When you go to Wally World and you sign a credit card receipt, you ain't got to do it that way. But driver's licenses and hospital bills, then that's the way you're going to do it.
Really?
Yeah. This is a certificate of indebtedness to be paid through the United States Department of the Treasury, 1789. Not drawn on the United States Department of the Treasury, but to be paid through the United States Department of the Treasury.
Really? You don't want them to exempt from levy, dispose of levy, the levy's broke, so Katrina happened? You don't want to do nothing?
Nope, don't want to do none of that stuff. And then this document has some laws in support of itself. Okay? Now, some of the language comes from the document that was filed. However, I received the paperwork today, the information showing, and I'll do another video on that, where the Treasury is claiming that they own all of you. Where the United States is claiming it owns all of you. Haven't had a chance to go over it too much going over today. Okay, now, let's talk about the lawsuit. Uno momento. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm back. You see, I'm the type of person, if somebody's shooting right outside my door, I'll go out there and see who's shooting. Not because I'm nosy, but because I'm saying, what do you think you're doing? And so, because this is that turkey stupid day, and a lot of you do it every year, some of you don't know any better. I don't celebrate holidays, not because I'm one of Jehovah's Witnesses. You know, I had somebody get mad at me because I say that I am a Jehovah's Witness. And he actually told me how much he didn't appreciate me using that name and saying that I was one of his witnesses. He actually had the audacity to say that to me. The audacity. And I kept my tongue. But I did tell him. He said that I forgot the word he used, but he used a particular word to describe my claiming to be. And I told him, oh, no. I didn't say I am one of Jehovah's Witnesses. I think it was something about I didn't claim to be. I am one of Jehovah's Witnesses. See, I wear that as a badge of honor. And this person had the audacity to tell me what he liked and didn't like about it. We don't get to have that debate unless I get to critique you and criticize you. And if I critique and criticize you, you're not going to like me. You're going to hate me. You see, I hold my tongue when it comes to what I like and do not like about other people's choices as to the direction in life. I have to hold my tongue because a tongue is like a guillotine, a sword, a knife, a jagged edge. It can cause damage. I'm not here to cause damage. Let's get on with the document. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do the best we can to get through this document. Like I said, I'm tired. This is probably not the best time for me to be doing this. But y'all hear Smokey? He's telling y'all exactly how I feel. All right. This item is to serve as a certified bonded coupon and is accompanied by a certificate of indebtedness and is paid to the Order of the United States of America without recourse and the United States Department of the Treasury without recourse.
You made it payable to both?
That's right.
Why'd you make it payable to both?
Because I just don't give a... I'm sorry, Tupac, you know? I did it that way because I felt like doing it that way. You don't have to do it. You know, Robinson, but not enough twice. We get rid of the first one and we move past the second one. All right, let's go on. Wait, who is this? I don't know who this be. This be Stevie Ray Vaughan. Oh, now that's interesting. I know of Stevie Ray Vaughan, but I didn't know this was him because I didn't listen to him. I just know of him. Stevie Ray! Oh, Stevie! Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, let's see if we can explain something to you. Here in Puerto Rico, they didn't like the fact that I signed my presentments up top. And this is not supposed to be settlor, L-O-R. My computer doesn't like that. It does like that spelling. It didn't like it before. Anyway, let's go on. That's who you are. That's who I am. I don't know who you are. You have to describe who you are. You have to give people an understanding of who you are. I can't. All right, let's see if we can go on. Your name, of the family of, and then you put of the family of, like mine is Brett, son of Isaac Jones. So when they say, well, your name is Brett Jones. No, my name is Brett, and you're forgetting the middle part, son of Isaac Jones.
What do you mean?
Well, that's my name.
Your name is not Brett Jones?
No. How could I have two names at one time? Do you know that's illegal? Are you telling me you want me to commit an illegal act to be two persons at one time? That's a felony. Okay, you get me?
Then you put your address to include physical address. Okay? Without the United States, you need to put that language if you're going to do it the way I'm suggesting you do it. Then you're going to label it because nobody can tell you how to do your presentments to the court. Only you get to tell them how you do your presentments. Suit in common law. And this document is called Small Claims Action Template. And it will be on the web probably by the end of Friday. Suit in common law.
Friday the 23rd.
A 7th and 11th Amendment right. Presented before the common law court of, and you put the city. Within the state or /territory, and then you put the, if it's not one of the 13 colonies, you put like New Mexico. Within the state or territory of New Mexico, okay, because it's a territory. If it's a state, then you do state. But if it's a territory, you get rid of state and you leave territory. Anything that's not part of the original 13 colonies is a territory. Why? Because the Constitution was created with the 13 colonies and not with anything else. Everything else is just a territory. But they became states later. Yes, they did. But Congress had already become a corporation. And all of their laws had already become codes by the time many of them became states. So they're not officially states. You don't believe me? Look at the flags that are still flying. Look at where the capital of the United States of North America is.
It's in Washington, D.C.
Technically. But where's the capital for the corporation, United States of North America?
It's in Washington, D.C.
Technically, but not true. We won't talk about that right now. It's not the point. Just telling you how we're doing things. And you put the county of in the name of the county. Still a corporation. All right. The first part. You put your name. First name, then the family of. The same way you did it up top. The defendant's name. In all capital letters. Because that's what you're suing, a corporation. You don't want to sue another man. You don't want to sue another living man. Suit in law. Matter in controversy or controversy. Deprivation of entitlements. Deprivation of rights secured by the Constitution. Trespass. Denial of due process. Interference with the right to contract. Failure to disclose. Denial of equal protection of law. Violation of the laws of humanity. And the Uniform Commercial Code, Article 3, Article 8, Article 9. Okay? And we want to do... Uh-oh. That ain't supposed to be there. Article 3, supposed to be a comma after the 3. Article 8, it'd be a comma after Article 8, comma, and Article 9. That's the way it's supposed to be. All right? Let's go on. We're not going to read the whole thing because this document is going to be up. I'm just going to explain to you what you're doing. Everything you produce to the court, even when you get a traffic ticket, you should be filing one of these. Okay? Ain't that peculiar? Declaration, affidavit, acknowledgement, common law, cause of action. They were playing this on the radio when we were driving to California, and I told them this is the same beat, probably the same group. But let's just say during that time, whenever you find songs by the same group and the melody sounds the same and the rhythm sounds the same, that's because they let no time go in between the writing of the next song. That happened with me when I would write the little short stories I would write. If I wrote them too close to each other, they would have certain similarities. So I had to wait weeks before I could write something else because it allows your brain to see new angles of thought. Well, that's just a side note. The same thing with writing things like this. Introduction of status. Now, is this required? No, this is what we are doing, which makes sense to us. Uh-oh, that's too big, son. Can somebody give that man a witness? Hey, I'm a witness! Well, he's not asking for that kind of witness. Oh. Well, you asked for a witness. He ain't saying what type of witness he... No, he's asking for a different witness. Okay. My name is... First name only. Of the family, father's first name and last name. Of the town and city of... City of purported birth and where you grew up. I declare, as well as I don't care if you don't have a city where you grew up in, a town where you were born and all this stuff. That's not my problem. You figure out how to write that. Do not contact me asking me questions like that. It is not my place to tell you what to put there. That's why it's in yellow. You have to figure out what goes there. I thought you weren't supposed to put I. Anyway, I declare as well as affirm that I am not a collective entity or an artificial construct. I got to get rid of this song because now it's definitely going to sound like the last song. Get rid of the first one. And let's go to that one. Y'all know this song by the Four Tops. I declare as well as a I declare. Ooh, Scarlet. Anyway, I declare as well as affirm that I am not a collective entity or an artificial construct, a corporation, a legal person, a legal fiction, but a living sentient... Excuse me. There's another word. Uh-oh. A living soul. Sentient. Real man or woman goes next. With inalienable and... supposed to be uninalienable. Uh-oh, ain't supposed to be that un. That's all caps. What type of fool is he? Uninalienable rights are entitlements, not rights. Entitlements. Certain things you are entitled as a matter of inheritance for being you, for being a living man or woman. I further declare and affirm that I do not consent to a judicial tribunal of any sort, that I do not consent to an administrative hearing of any sort, that I do not consent to having mind matter and controversy heard before officers of a corporation at any level. I have the right and am entitled to redress. Sorry. Due process of law and equal protection of law. Let's get rid of the ofs, people. Just remember, we're going to do in-law. The same as we found out about suit in-law. The wording is everything. Due process in law and equal protection in law. And I do hereby knowingly, deliberately, intentionally, and willingly exercise those rights. It should be these. Give me 1 second, folks. And entitlements. And entitlements. Sorry, I got things popping up. Let me get rid of those. Let me try the and entitlements one more time. I don't feel like typing. Now I got to be very careful about speaking because it comes back on when it feels like it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is Maxwell, and I like this song an awful lot. Maxwell, let the people know. He has this one, which is called Softly, and he has another one called Symphony. And let's just say I'm a fan. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. Yep, that's what happened. It was still on when I was doing all that talking. The system's doing a lot of stuff in the background. I have a more powerful unit. When I changed computers, when I came from California, I took the computer I had, which was comparable to what I had. But because I got it from a pawn shop, they allowed me to go back and upgrade within 6 months. And so I have something that memory's upgradable and everything. It's a Dell. You got a Dell? And basically, it now has everything I need. The speed I need, I just need to load up all the programs. Okay, let's continue. I further affirm as well as declare that I object to any violation of my rights. Got to do an entitlements again. Let's go up here. We don't have to turn on voice recognition.
Oh, baby, why you wanna just treat me like you do? Oh.
Sorry, I like the song. And sorry, all of my automobiles have a sound system in it. So what you can't hear is the bass in this song and the melody and how everything blends in. See, a lot of you may not appreciate it. You see the people riding around in their cars with the music blasting. Now, for some of you, you think they're just blasting music. Now, if they're just playing any old stupid song, then they're just blasting music. They're just trying to get people's attention and they're trying to blow their eardrums. But when you get people like me where you can hear the highs, the lows, all of the words, and the melody, then those individuals are playing it because of the music and not because they want people to pay attention to them. You see, I drive down the highway the same way, and I cruise. See, even this part right here. If you don't believe me, just try it. It's called Softly. It's by Maxwell. And when you play this song, I promise you you'll fall in love with it. I guarantee it.
Is that R&B? I can't stand R&B.
Well, you know what? I can't stand R&B either. But let me tell you something. Because they give a song a label. Ladies and gentlemen, I like Hotel California. I believe it was done by the Eagles. And then you had Al B. Shore. I said, Al B. Shore. He did the song. You know where his name came from? It came from a rapper known as Slick Rick.
I have to hear one more before I'll be sure.
That's where his name came from. Just like Warren G, his name came from, dang it. KRS-One, Love's Gonna Get You. Talking about Warren. W-A-R-I-N-G. Warring. Well, they took that and came up with Warren G. Warring G. Warring. Okay. So that's where Warren G's name came from. Yeah, you learn a little bit of something every once in a while. But I'm a fan of KRS-One, Warren G, Tupac, fan of a lot of people. Bjork, love Bjork. And Craig Armstrong, because he did that song, the album, The Space Between Us. Very, 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 very much a music connoisseur. All right, let's continue, shall we? Corporation at any level, I have the right and am entitled to redress and due process in law. We've already done that. I further affirm, as well as declare, that I object to any violation of my rights and entitlements, whether known to me at present or stated within this presentment or divulged within the course of this matter. And the objection is sustained henceforth, forthwith, and wait, heretofore. Okay. Why did I put the objection is sustained? Because I'm the one making the objection. If I object to something, can't nobody overrule me? That would make him greater than me. And he doesn't get to do it, so I am bringing forth all of the presumptions. Is that what you're doing? That's right, I'm bringing forth all of the presumptions. I am making a declaration from the get-go, from the gate. Really? Let's continue. I promise you, you're going to like what I'm doing. I further declare, as well as affirm, that I object to this matter being presented before a corporation, corporation officers, corporation officials, collective entities, artificial constructs, legal fictions, legal persons, legal individuals, and anything related to or having, is supposed to be, or voice recognition, or having to deal with a citizen of the United States company corporation. Just that simple. I don't need to say anything else. I just said everything in that one sentence. And that's what I do. As a real man or woman, however you want to put it there, I have no owner but the one who created. It's supposed to be the one who created my foreparents, not by foreparents. My. And let's make sure that's the correct four. It's supposed to be F-O-R-E. Foreparents. On or about 4026 BCE. Now, why did you put 4026 BCE? We're going to put a hyphen there. Should have just put the hyphen instead of doing the correction. Because the Bible has, when you do the Bible chronology, 4026 is according to all of the things written in there where Adam was said to have been created. And I claim and I profess and I declare that he is my forefather. Okay. That I possess freedom of mind, freedom of intellect, freedom of choice, freedom of thought, freedom of movement, freedom of to travel, freedom of travel, freedom to redress, and freedom within common law. This is just something I added because I wanted to let them know who I am. I hereby declare that this matter to be a controversy in excess of $20, to be a matter within the scope and rules of common law. Why did I put that?
Because the 7th Amendment of the United States Constitution says that any matter that is in excess or exceeds $20 and is a controversy is to be conducted under common law, the rules of common law, and the right to a common law jury shall never be denied.
Is that what it says?
That's what it says in essence. Essence. Who gets essence?
Okay. And as a member and one of the people of the United States of North America, We want to do... As a member of the public and one of the people of the United States of North America, an inheritor of the land, a non-citizen national, I bring forth my complaint and charge the defendants with the following.
You mean to tell me all of that was just an introduction? How many pages is that?
According to this, 2 pages. 2 complete pages.
Charge number 1, not count. Charge.
That's why we're not counting. All right, let's continue. On or about, enter the date, and you don't have to be exact. So let's just say an incident happened yesterday. I can put on and about October 15th, 2012, if I chose to, because on or about means that it is not specific. The defendants did the following acts knowingly, willingly, deliberately, intentionally, and participated in ongoing conspiracy to subject the presenter to deprivation of entitlements. Okay, you put the information in between where it says did the following acts knowingly and ongoing conspiracy. You put the information after entitlements. You fill in the blank. You say what they did and do not be specific. Be general. The specifics come out during trial, and if any judge asks you for specifics, tell them he is not. You ask for a jury. They will handle the specifics. You will deal with generalities. They violated your rights. They did it knowingly, and they participated in the conspiracy. Well, how did they participate in the conspiracy? Because this entity was involved, that entity was involved, and they did it knowingly. And it's more than one defendant. Just that simple. You don't have to explain to that idiot all the details so that he can pick your details apart. That's not his job, and we've been allowing these idiots to do stupid things like that.
Ooh, you sound fired up, boy.
I'm not fired up.
Fired up!
Okay. Charge number 2. On or about, remember the date does not have to be exact. The defendants did the following knowingly, blah, 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 and participate in ongoing conspiracy to subject the presenter to deprivation of rights secured by the Constitution. Remember, the Constitution does not give you rights. It only backs them up.
Oh, I learned something.
Now here's the next one. On or about the blah, blah, blah. The defendants is the following knowingly, willingly. Remember, there has to be intent. So when you say knowingly, willingly, deliberately, intentionally, supposed to be some commas there, so we're going to correct that now, because we'll forget to do it later. This is just me rushing. So, rushing? I didn't know you were a Russian. I's a Russian. I don't know how to be anything else. Been a Russian all my life. You've been a Russian all your life. How come nobody else knew? Because nobody knew me all my life but me. Yes, I'll correct the other ones, but since the page is shifting because I have it set at the resolution it's set to, I gotta do those separately. So right now we're just gonna take care of all these, and then we're gonna work our way back up. Okay, gotta put the commas in there for y'all, not for me, because I don't need commas. I run off at the mouth, so my sentences can be run off sentences too.
You mean run on, don't you know? I said run off, and I said it because I meant it,
because I am somebody. Say it for me again, because I can't hear you.
I say it. I am
somebody. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay. All right. Now, we go over here, and we do the others. Uh-oh. You went too far. You're still going too far. Stop it.
Stop in the name of us before you miss the bus. Stop. In the name of God, before you leave the hood, think it over.
Okay, yes, I'm an idiot. We're going to take care of all these now. Cause
you know, you forgot a comma in charge number 5 and charge number 68. Where the commas at in between intentionally, knowingly, willingly, deliberately, and willfully? Where they at?
That's what I deal with, people. I deal with it all the time. and I have to bite my tongue. Some people say, and I'm going to tell it to you like it is. One person saw how I conducted myself at the event, and he saw everything that I was going through, and he kept his mouth shut. He didn't really announce it to people, didn't say anything, kept his mouth shut. But you could see that it was irritating him, that he would have handled it differently. And he said this to me, and I need to make sure that you all understand. The conversation among young black males is different than it would be between older black males. So when a young black male tell me in these words, "You are a better nigga than I am," some of you will be offended by that. Some of you will take that negative, but I understand exactly the context it was being said in, and I understood exactly what he was saying, because as I told you all, I understand. Now, some people, not everybody, must understand the use of that word. That's not a word that young black males use all the time. It's not like every word coming out of their mouth is that word. And so many people have gotten a misunderstanding and a disunderstanding because it's an ignorance that you understood whatever you understood. That word is not the same as the other word that was created, invented, and mutilated that deals with ignorance, stupidity, and juvenile moronicy. Moronicy? That's right. I create words all the time. It's called ebonics. But mine is bebonics, okay? Okay, I can do that. Yes, this is my world. But when he said that, I understood. And I looked, and I saw the look on his face, and I saw the frustration on his face, because I knew that he knew that he would never stand for that. He would never remain silent. I chose not to acquiesce, but I chose not to make a big deal. All right, let's continue. I further attest and affirm that the rules of any corporation and or policy and or procedure were not meant for me, the real man, and that the rules and or procedures for the court are for the officers of the corporation and not for me, the real man. I have a right and am entitled to a jury trial under common law, with common law rules as prescribed by the 7th Amendment to the United States Constitution, which supports and attests to my rights and entitlements. See, told you. It is my goal to seek a remedy of the maximum penalty allowed within the scope of the law. Not under the scope of the law, but within the scope of the law. Let's give them a hyphen so they can say we're dealing within the law and not under the law. Don't you people get it? They play word games all the time. So think about it. Just sit back and think about it. Which one is it? Is it within the law or under law? I declare under penalty of perjury. Why would you want to be under the penalty of perjury? Now you're subjected to it. Now you become its slave. No, we want to be within the law. Want to be in line with the law. Okay? So, we're going to be within the scope of the law. That is to include, but not be limited to, punitive as well as compensatory damages. I demand that the payment be in a form of or currency outlined by the joint session of Congress at its highest valued rate at the time that these incidents occurred, and or the completion of this matter, whichever occurs first and has the highest value. Okay, because if they change the currency, you want to make sure that you don't get that old currency. There were several cases the Supreme Court did that did exactly the same thing, where the new currency outvalued the old currency. Yep, that's what they did. That's the case we talked about that case. That's the Ohio Railroad case, 1935. Supreme Court made its decision in 35. All right. By presenting this complaint before this common law venue, I retain all of my rights, entitlements, and status. I surrender them unto no man or woman or organization or collective entity or legal fiction or any other jurisdiction. Yes, I know there's and or Okay. Let's do it right. I like the and or, but I was speaking fast. And we should have that, see, should be the actual and or symbol, because that's what the forward slash stands for.
Ooh, this is my girl. Y'all just don't know. This is my old honey child. This is my girl.
All right, this matter is to remain a matter at, in, and under common law throughout its duration, to include appeal and transference to any other jurisdiction. It has come to the presenter's attention that this body practices a law and a language known as legalese, and such a language is foreign to me, and I have no concept of its wording. If this body chooses and insists on using legalese, I object forcefully to such an implementation. I have a right to have this matter heard in English, the official language of the United States of North America, as enacted by Congress, or to have an impartial real man and or real woman. Let's get that and or thing going. Forward slash. Need my forward slash. To be a translator throughout all proceedings. Impartial means she cannot work for the state if this information involves going after the state. The aforementioned is true and correct and presented with this certificate of indebtedness attached here too. On this date, we put the date. Oh, by the way, that certificate of indebtedness, that was the thing we covered first. That certificate, that bond certificate, that's the certificate of indebtedness that we attach to our lawsuit. They want payment, that's payment. And it's certified by affixing my autograph at the top of this presentment.
Now, wait, how could that be payment? What if the judge say they want cash or check?
Tell them that the law says USC Title 31, Section 5118, that they cannot demand cash. It is against the law for them to do so.
You mean?
Well, then you're going to have to do your research. Delete this section before copying and printing. You will print this so as to cover both sides of the document. So page one is on one side of the page, and the back of page one is page two, and then so on. So you're going to do front and back. And yes, some of you are going to have to work with your printers to do front and back. So that means you're going to have to print page one, page three, page five, page seven, page 11, and page nine. Sorry. Then you're going to have to do 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, then 12. Yeah, you can mess up if you don't do it right. So let's get it good. You will utilize both sides of every page, and you will put a 2-cent stamp at the bottom right-hand corner of the second page and sign your name through it. All of the highlighted areas you will fill in and delete the parentheses. See, anything in parentheses, we don't use parentheses in our instruments, in our presentments. This is a parenthesis. You want to delete everything in the highlighted area and fill it in without the highlights. Okay? Remember, the clerk of the court is not going to like this document, but let them know that the law says that you have the right to do this and that they cannot read your document. They can only see if it purports, if it has the proper indicators. What are these? A so-called plaintiff and presenter and defendant, a case title, a listing of allegation or charges, a signature or autograph, an affirmation or an attesting to, and an address for which you may be contacted. Those are the only things that are required. If they give you a problem, demand to speak to a supervisor. Demand that it be taken before a judge so that the judge can make the determination. If they tell you you must utilize their form, you ask them to show you the law where it says you must do that, because all of their rules say that you do not have to use their form, F-O-R-M. That includes multiple forms, which adds an S, forms. So you don't have to use their form mat or their forms. The Supreme Court said as much in 1879 under the Judiciary Act of 1789. Got the numbers transposed, you know, that a pro se's presentment cannot be dismissed because of lacking in form. their forms or theirs. And anytime any of you ever get a judge, prosecutor, attorney, anybody saying that you copied and pasted from a website, then you just pull out one of the forms of the court or ask them, do they supply forms for individuals to fill in the blank? So that means that the court is practicing in the same practice and the same act, and you are permitted and authorized and allowed to do the exact same thing, because equal protection of law protects you the same way it protects them. Oh, I had it right here. It's tell them to show you the law that says you must do that, and then you show them the law that violates, because this law, then you ask them to show you that law that violates the Judiciary Act of 1789, which states pro se litigants pleadings may not be dismissed due to lacking in form. Ladies and gentlemen, let me get rid of this junk. You know what? I know which ones it is. It's this one too. It's all the ones with numbers. So let's get, that's my boy. For now, we won't be hearing it no more. We ain't gonna go to this many songs, but let me get rid of all the ones with numbers in front so we don't have no more problems. But them are some nice songs you're getting rid of. Yep, but just in case there's a problem, because I noticed something that they all had in common. They had numbers in front. And so if we get rid of many of the ones that have numbers in front, we ain't got no problem. No, wait a minute. There's another one that has numbers in front. Let's do this one. Nope, already done that. Same song, too. Sorry, I was in a rush when I put this together. But I want y'all to know that we're going to take a little trip on the caravan of love. Yeah, always like this song. All right. When I put pro se litigants pleadings may not be dismissed due to lacking in form, I wasn't reading from the screen. I know that by heart. Okay? Because it's every pro se case that's ever been dismissed because of lacking in form has always been overturned, and it's always been this phrase that has always been put on all of the remanding documents from the appeals court. Remember, first, do not allow the... Okay, I see what the problem is here. This is supposed to be two. And this is supposed to be them. Do not allow them to call you pro se. Do not allow them to call you a litigant. Refer to yourself as the presenter and keep referring to yourself as the presenter. It is the court clerks who will give you the biggest problem. They are there to prevent you from filing, for you to fill out their forms, putting you in their jurisdiction. You don't want to argue with them. You simply want them to show you the policy, to show you the law, to provide the information that proves that you are obligated under such policies and such laws. They have their procedures. So don't argue with them about their procedures. What they do not is the right to demand that you follow their procedures, because they're not your procedures, it's theirs. As far as handling of the case itself, you want to send a copy of the complaint to the defendants, all of them, along with the summons. You have to send a copy of the summons to the defendants. The summons document you can utilize from the court. Well, technically, I make my own copy. I present my own summons. Now, they hate that. I have a court here in Puerto Rico, the same one that didn't like me signing at the top. Both of them didn't like it, but I told them, I stood my ground. I told them I have a right. One court I had to go through, and it's an hour away. And I had to go to them three times telling them, hey, this is the last time because I'm not playing this. I know what I'm doing. Well, you have to put this in Spanish. I don't have to put this in nothing. I will do this in English. This is a territory of the United States, and Congress has ruled that the United States official language is English. Man, that didn't go over well, but it got filed in English. All right. For your service of process, you can utilize United States Postal Service by sending it certified mail and or delivery confirmation. They're both about the same. The United States, and you don't need to get the green card. When you send it certified mail, you don't need to use the green card. You can just go online to prove that it was delivered and copy it from online. The United States Postal Service is the official process server for the United States government. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not reading that from the screen. Everything on the screen is my words. I know this. Why do I know this? Because I've been filing lawsuits since 1986. On and off throughout that whole period.
Oh, you old.
Well, no, in 1986, I was about 18 years old. Okay, so let's just say I got my feet wet a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
If the government can utilize them, so can you. If the government can utilize the Postal Service, so can you. Once the parties are served, you're going to include with your service the complaint, the summons, and a discovery notice. And you typically ask the following. Now, notice this. Nobody does discovery with service, but I do. Any and all records, microfilm, tape, recordings, video, audio, computer-generated products, documents associated with this matter, with your
legal fiction straw man
corporate name, whether associated or with this matter or not, they will argue that this is privileged information. So before they do, you mention to them that the use of your name is now prohibited, revoked, and that they do not have any rights to any proprietary use of your name or files associated with your name. In other words, they don't get to keep secrets from you.
No!
Gotta put another parenthesis, because this section you're not gonna leave attached, okay? Then, if it is involving a mortgage, any and all records, microfilm, tapes, recordings, videos, audios, computer-generated products, documents associated with this matter to include but not be limited to
the mortgage default insurance,
the carrier, a copy of a policy, a copy of any and all documentation of such policy, and when such policy was enacted, as well as a copy of any and all claims associated with the policy, a full statement of accounting referencing the policy, and the name of the beneficiary, grantor, or trustee. Make sure you indicate that the names that coincide with the aforementioned three is sufficient.
Beneficiary, grantor, trustee.
A complete and full validation of debt, verification of debt, signed by an officer of the corporation authorized to make such certifications, verifications, and validations. That you want access to the original contract with the original ink signature, and for them to produce a copy of the loss document on file, that they filed a loss. For any loss or missing notes and or contracts, and an explanation as to when such contracts became missing, and why did they fail to notify you. Here are two things you need to know. I was, before I read that, we were doing validation authorized certificate verified. I had a thought that came to mind that I wanted to tell you. Them to produce a copy of the loss document. They have to produce that, because when they lose a contract, they're supposed to notify you, and they're supposed to also notify the SEC that it has been lost. Uniform Commercial Code, presentment and payment. I think it's section 600 of Article 3 that talks about that. But there was something else I was wanting to bring to your attention. The verification of debt. Oh, there's something else that you're going to need to ask for. When we talked about loss, that's the part where I was hanging on to. They get tax breaks. When they get tax breaks or tax credits, that's considered as compensation. But they don't credit your account for that. And so that's what you want to highlight. Okay? All right, let's continue. You must also let them know that none of the information you're requesting is privileged, and that they must organize it in such a way where each of the items you're requesting is specifically identified, that the items that you're requesting must be outlined in such a form that the information you're requesting is readily available without your having to search through each of the specific documents for the specific information, that they must provide written correspondence showing how each of the documents that are sent to you, any and all records, microfilm, tapes, recordings, videos, audio recordings, computer-generated product, documents associated with this matter, or related to each and every page, document, audio file, microfilm, tape, recording, video, computer-generated document you receive from them. In other words, they can't just send you 25,000 boxes for you to search through the information. Okay, just that simple. This is discovery. You're being specific about your request, and so they're going to have to provide specific answers. They can't just throw the whole file at you and say, you search for it, because that's not your job. It's their job to provide discovery, specific discovery, not just general discovery. That's why you're not asking for general discovery. Okay? Ladies and gentlemen, as tired as I am, it got done. I just found out I'm on Atlantic time, not Eastern time, and I've been having people telling people to call me on Eastern time. So those of you who are in Eastern time, I'm 1 hour ahead of you. Those of you who are on Mountain time, I am 3 hours ahead of you. Those of you who are on Central time, I am 2 hours ahead of you. In California, I'm 4 hours ahead of you. So I am so, so sorry to all of you, because, hey, I live in Atlantic time. Didn't know it existed. Well, I knew it existed, but when I came to Puerto Rico, the times were matching. My phone was matching. The time and everything was matching. I just never understood that when I left Florida and came to Puerto Rico, I lost an hour. Interesting. So my plane flight, instead of being 2.5 hours, only an hour and a half. Whereas if I would not have taken JetBlue, and we're going to talk about JetBlue in a second, because their agents who went through my bags did some damage, and I was going to praise them and give them all kind of, you know, kudos. But JetBlue, even when I called to complain, they actually gave me an attitude and told me about their policies and procedures. Ladies and gentlemen, if I have to sue everybody who causes me stupid problems, I would never have time to do any of this. I'd be in court every single day of the week. And that's not me. All right, this is an appropriate song. It should be Don't Mess With Brett, because they keep trying to try me, and I don't have time to be tried. Okay. When you file your case, your certificate of indebtedness is what you're going to use to pay the court fees. It is basically an IOU, and you can use the Treasury hour-style money orders as your certificate of indebtedness, or the recent one that we just put up on the internet the same day of this document. That document won't be up until probably Friday or Saturday morning. We will label it triple, 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 triple A, or quad, triple, quadruple, A, quadruple zero A, so 0000 AA, 1 or 2. So basically it'll be 0001 or 0002. Okay, this one will probably be this document 1, and that document will probably be 2. So that they'll be easier to find. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the conclusion of this video. We want you to understand these are just templates. They're just basic ideas. You can do this document however you want. But I'm going to tell you, do not make the la, 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 la. We want you thing. We don't want your documents looking like their documents completely, because we don't want to fall within their realm of understanding and doing things. So our documents are going to look like our documents. You understand? I understand. All right, thank you all for paying attention to this. This video will be called Small Claims Action Template. Might as well call it what it is. I know we talked about things before this, but that's what this one's going to be called. All right. See y'all later. Take care, people.
Hi, this is Robert Masterson. I just wanted to let all of you know.
Wait,
you want to do the best we can and get you what you need, mission. What you need, all you need.
Information. What else
Are you with me? Oh.
Accomplish something!
The
no, that's not the way to do it! We're gonna accomplish something!